sun sets free, always free indeed. Now my debt is paid, it is paid in full by the precious blood that my Jesus spilled. Now the curse of sin has no hold on me. Whom the sun sets free, always free. Now my debt is paid, it is paid in full by the precious blood that my Jesus spilled. Now the curse of sin has no hold on me. Greatest love that anyone could ever know, it overcame the cross and grave to find my soul. Till I see you face to face, grace amazing takes me home. I trust in you. With all I am, I live to see your kingdom come. And in my heart, I pray you let your will be done. Until I see you face to face, and grace amazing takes me home, I trust in you. to bring you praise. I will lift the child in awe of you. You alone are God of all. You
God, we praise you with all that we are this morning, for you are wholly worthy. You've poured yourself out for us for the sake of love. You overcame the cross and grave to set us free, and we can't thank you enough. And this is the least we can do, to live a life of worship unto you. This time we'll be moving into a time of worship in the Word, and today we'll be meditating on Psalm 29 and singing through this passage. I invite you to open up your Bibles with me to Psalm 29 verses 1 through 11. Once again, the passage is Psalm 29 verses 1 through 11. Psalm 29 verses 1 to 2. Ascribe to the Lord, O heavenly beings, ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name. Worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness. Lord, we ascribe you worth and glory today. By your glory and might, we are called mighty ones. You are worthy to be honored and praised. You are altogether worthy, O God. You are set apart above the rest. There is none like you, none who come close. As we exalt your name, would you receive all the glory? Get your glory, Lord, and reveal more of yourself to us as we praise you. We thank you that in the presence of your glory, nothing else matters. That all else, the worries of this world, the doubts, the burdens, the fatigue, fades away in the brightness, the joy, and the rest that comes with your holy presence.
Oh, we ascribe to you, we ascribe to the Lord. We join the angel song, we praise you, we give you glory. Ascribe to the Lord, O heavenly beings. Ascribe to the Lord, glory and strength. Oh, ascribe to the Lord, the glory due his name. We worship you, Lord, the splendor of your holiness. We worship you, oh, we worship you. worship you. We ascribe to you. We ascribe to the Lord. We ascribe to you. We give you praise. We give you honor. So we join the angel song, and we declare, let everything that has breath, won't you praise the Lord, let's praise the Lord. Take a second just to remember your goodness, God. Oh, we take a moment to remember who you are, and from that place of thankfulness, oh God, we give you thanks. Oh God, we give you glory. We just take a moment to remember. Praise God from that place of thanksgiving and thankfulness. Oh God, we give you the glory, give you the honor, give you the praise. Let's do all your name. We give you the praise. Let's do your name.
Thankfulness, God, Lord,
From that place of thanksgiving, we give you praise. Oh, worship the Lord in the splendor of His holiness, His holiness. And God, we give you our worship. We give you our thoughts. We give you our everything. Give you our everything. We remember why you're worthy to be praised. We remember why you're so good, our good Father. We ascribe to the Lord. We extol His name. Oh, we give Him praise. Give Him glory to His name, and we'll worship the Lord. Oh, we'll worship the Lord from that place. The splendor of Your holiness, Your holiness. So we remember, God, how holy You are. You are holy, God. There is none like You, there's no one like You, God, our holy God. You are different, You are holy, so holy.
With Your holiness, God, Your
look at you. Oh God, our Creator, the one who we're made in the image of. And God, we ask, remind us that, Lord, you call us to be a holy people, a people set apart just like you. We want to be like you, so God, make us holy, just as you are holy, God. God, make us holy, just as you are. Want to be holy. We want to be holy like you. So won't you set us apart, make us different? 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 Set us apart, won't you set us apart, make us different? Won't you set us apart and make us different? Won't you set us apart, make us different? We want to be holy like you. We want to be holy like you. Won't you? Set us apart, make us different. Won't you set us apart and make us different? Won't you set us apart, make us different? Won't you set us apart and make us different? Won't you set us apart? Won't you set us apart? Make us different. Would you set us apart? Make us different. Would you set us apart? Make us different. Would you set us apart? Make us different. Yeah, God.
Psalm 29, verses 3 to 5. The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The God of glory thunders, the Lord over many waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. The Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon. God, we acknowledge the power of your voice. Your voice thunders over the expanses. Your voice roars, and all of creation obeys. Lord, you don't have to try to make yourself heard or to make something happen. As you will something and speak it, so it will be. You hold all authority, and your words hold weight, force, and strength. And even the hardest of trees break at the sound of your voice. Because your words bring breakthrough. You are a God of breakthrough. And the hardest of hearts and hardest of places are not even hard to you. We praise you that the same God who spoke the world into existence is the one who speaks to us, over us, and through us, even now.
The voice of the Lord is over the waters. God of glory, he thunders. Oh, the Lord over many waters. Oh, we listen. For the voice of the Lord is powerful, so powerful. The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The voice of the Lord is over the waters of my soul. It's on my soul. The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The voice of the Lord, oh, it thunders. So God, we see your voice. We acknowledge your voice, oh God. We know that your voice is over the waters. No matter what's going on, we remember your voice. Remember your still small voice, the voice that thunders, that thunders. So won't you speak to us? Oh, we listen to your voice. And we say, oh God, more and more, more and more. Cause the voice of the Lord is over the waters. In every season and circumstance, the voice of the Lord is over the waters. In every season and circumstance, the voice of the Lord is over the waters. In every season and circumstance, the voice of the Lord is over the waters. In every season and circumstance, oh, the voice of the Lord is over the waters. In every season and circumstance, the voice of the Lord is over the waters. In every season and circumstance, the voice of the Lord, the voice of the Lord is over the waters. In every season and circumstance, the voice of the Lord is over the waters. In every season and circumstance, oh, voice of the Lord, and voice of the Lord is over the waters. In every season and circumstance, the voice of the Lord is over the waters. In every season and circumstance, voice of the Lord, and voice of the Lord is over the waters. In every season and circumstance, the voice of the Lord is over the waters. In every season and circumstance, oh, the voice of the Lord, it thunders over the waters. The voice of the Lord, it's powerful, so powerful. The voice of the Lord, it knows no end. It thunders, oh, it thunders, it's so powerful. It's so powerful, yeah.
Bye.
second to remember how powerful your voice is. The voice of the Lord, that's powerful, so powerful. And we remember where that voice comes from. It comes from the God of the universe. That same voice that speaks to us, called the universe to be. It made everything out of nothing. That's the voice that speaks to us, and the voice that's powerful. The voice that's full of majesty. The voice of the Lord is powerful, so powerful. The voice of the Lord, it's full of majesty and power. And Lord, we know that your voice, it breaks the cedars, because it's so powerful to us. Of the Lord, it breaks the cedars, and from that voice comes our breakthrough. So God, we prophesy over the areas we need you, God, and we say, Lord, won't you speak, won't you speak. We prophesy, won't you speak into those circumstances, those situations, God. Bring those breakthroughs. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. And the voice of the Lord, it brings the breakthrough. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. The voice of the Lord brings the breakthrough. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. The voice of the Lord brings the breakthrough. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. The voice of the Lord brings the breakthrough.
Lord God, there is only one called worthy. Your glory shines above the rest, and your holiness is too great, too lofty to be understood. Let everything that has breath praise you and glorify you, and let us be filled with gratitude and awe as we reflect on who you are and how powerful your voice is. Thank you, Lord, that we can trust in the power of your voice.
Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing, great are you. shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great are you, Lord, and all the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Breath in our lungs, and we pour it back, and we pour out our praise.
Yes, Father God, we pour out our praise to you with the breath that you have given us. God, we love you, we honor you, and we thank you just for who you are and what you have revealed to us. We will now be continuing to worship through the scripture passage, Psalm 29. I invite you to open up to Psalm 29. Verses 6 through 11. Again, that's Psalm 29, verses 6 through 11. Psalm 29, verses 6 through 8. He makes Lebanon to skip like a calf, and Syrian like a young wild ox. The voice of the Lord flashes forth flames of fire. The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. The Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh. Lord, you make the trees and the mountains leap and shake with vigor. You make the earth quake as you sit unmoved from your place on the throne. And your voice uproots the cedars, and you toss the branches with such might that they skip about. Even the greatest things, the mountains in and around us that seem firm and established, are easily shaken and stirred by one simple word from you. And your voice is to be feared and revered. Lord, as your voice flashes forth fire and lightning, would you strike our hearts with words that consume and awaken, that bring passion? And as you shake even the deserts, the low and dry places, we acknowledge that you take down the high places and you raise up the low. And God, nothing remains as it seems when you speak. And every bit of this world shifts out of its place at the sound of your mighty voice.
Of the Lord, it makes Lebanon skip like a calf, and Syrian like a young wild ox. Oh, the voice of the Lord, oh, the voice of the Lord flashes forth flames of fire. Oh, the voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. So God, we ask, voice of the Lord, bring forth the fire. Oh, voice of the Lord, speak forth the flames of fire. Fire of your Holy Spirit, speak it forth, O God. Voice of the Lord, flash forth the flames of fire. For the fire, we ask for the flame, pour it out, O God, as we worship your name. We ask for the fire, We ask for the flame. Pour it out, oh God, as we worship your name. We ask for the fire. We ask for the flame. Pour it out, oh God, as we worship your name. We ask for the fire. We ask for the flame. Pour it out, oh God, as we worship your name. We ask for the fire. We ask for the flame. Pour it out, oh God, as we worship your name. We ask for the fire. We ask for the flame. Pour it out, oh God, as we worship your name. We ask for your fire. We ask for the flame. Pour it out, oh God, as we worship your name. We ask for the fire. We ask for the flame. Pour it out, oh God, as we worship. We ask. We ask for the fire. We ask for the flame. Pour it out, oh God, as we worship your name. We ask for the fire. We ask for the flame. Pour it out, oh God, as we worship your name. We ask for the fire. We ask for the flame. Pour it out, oh God, as we worship your name. We ask for the fire. We ask for the flame. Pour it out, oh God, as we worship your name.
Psalm 29, verses 9 through 11. The voice of the Lord makes the deer give birth and strips the forests bare, and in his temple all cry, glory. The Lord sits enthroned over the flood. The Lord sits enthroned as king forever. May the Lord give strength to his people. May the Lord bless his people with peace. The thunder of your voice, Lord God, hastens birth pangs to make way for new life. Just as you strip forests bare, you reveal the deep and hidden mysteries. We give you glory, God, and we cannot help but cry glory as we learn of your greatness. God, you are king over the flood. You sit enthroned, sovereign and unshakable. And your steadiness and control appear even more evident amidst the surrounding storm. And we praise you because you give your people strength and peace in the storm. You bless us and you spare us from the calamity and wrath of the storm around us. Thank you that this deeper knowledge of who you are gives us strength and grace to be steadfast because we know we are yours. And may we remain yours, that we also would not be shaken from our place.
The voice of the Lord makes a deer give birth and the strips the forest bare. We declare the voice of the Lord, oh, has the power to give life and to give death. And so, God, we ask for your voice to speak life. Oh, we know that the voice of the Lord can give life. So won't you speak life to us? Speak life over our lives, oh God. Won't you speak life over us? Give us that power.
From your voice, life begins and ends.
the deer gives birth. God, we ask for your voice to speak life over us. Cause we know from your voice, oh, there is life. Oh, we know from your voice, there is hope that restores. So from your voice, give us life. From your voice, give us hope. From your voice, give us love. And from your voice, give us life. Of the Lord strips the forest bare. So God, we ask that the voice of the Lord removes every hindrance and distraction. Cause God, we wanna be full of life. We wanna be full of hope. We wanna live for you. We want to love you more. So remove it all, remove the hindrances, remove the hardened heart, and God, won't you speak to our hearts right now, through the voice of the Lord. It's your voice that causes all in the temple cry glory, glory. We know it's your voice that gives us the right perspective. And we know it's your voice that speaks to us, that shows us who you are. that shows us who you are. And because of your voice, oh God, we cry, glory, glory. So, voice of the Lord, won't you show us who you are? Oh, voice of the Lord, come open up our hearts. Voice of the Lord, show us who you are. Voice of the Lord, come open up our hearts. And voice of the Lord, show us who you are. And voice of the Lord, come open up our hearts. And voice of the Lord, show us who you are. And voice of the Lord, come open up our hearts. And voice of the Lord, show us who you are. And voice of the Lord, open up our hearts. And voice of the Lord, show us who you are. Voice of the Lord, open up our hearts. And voice of the Lord, show us who you are. And voice of the Lord, open up our hearts. And voice of the Lord, show us who you are. Voice of the Lord, open up our hearts. And voice of the Lord, show us who you are. Voice of the Lord, open up our hearts. Voice of the Lord, show us who you are. Voice of the Lord, come on. Voice of the Lord, voice of the Lord, show us who you are. Voice of the Lord, open up our hearts. Voice of the Lord, show us who you are. Voice of the Lord, come open up our hearts. Cause God we know, cause God we know, that the Lord sits enthroned over the flood. Oh, we know that the Lord sits enthroned as King forever. So God, we exalt you, Lord. We acknowledge you, Lord, on the throne, on your throne, as King over the universe. We see you enthroned on your throne.
Okay.
voice, life begins and ends. And by your voice, things are shaken from their place. And we rightfully fear you, God. But we thank you that in your grace, you grant us peace and endurance amidst the storms, and you make us more like you, unintimidated by what our circumstances imply, and grounded in the strength of our Father. Thank you, Lord, for who you are. In Jesus' name.
Heaven thundered and the world was born. Life begins and ends in the dust you form. Faith commanded and the mountains move. Fear is losing ground to our hope in you. Heaven thundered and heaven thundered. Was born. Life begins and ends in the dust you form. Faith commanded and the mountains will. Fear is losing ground to a hope in you. Don't stop, oh God, let your glory go. Chains undone, sin defeated, Jesus has overcome, and mercy triumphed when the third day dawned. Darkness was denied when the storm was gone. Unstoppable God, let your glory go on and on. Impossible things in your name, they shall be done. Don't stop, oh God, let your glory go on and on. Impossible things in your name, they shall be done. Unstoppable, unstoppable God, let your glory go on and on. Impossible things in your name, they shall be done. Don't stop, oh God, let your glory go on and on. The impossible things in your name, they shall be done. Shall be impossible. Your kingdom reigns unstoppable. We'll shout your praise forevermore. Jesus, our God, unstoppable. Nothing shall be impossible. Your kingdom reigns unstoppable. We'll shout your praise forevermore. Jesus, our God, unstoppable. Nothing shall be impossible. Your kingdom reigns unstoppable. We'll shout your praise forevermore. Jesus, our God, unstoppable. nothing, nothing shall be impossible. Your kingdom reigns unstoppable. We'll shout your praise forevermore. Jesus, our God, oh, nothing, nothing shall be impossible. Your kingdom reigns unstoppable. We'll shout your praise forevermore. Jesus, our God, unstoppable. Your kingdom reigns unstoppable. We'll shout your praise forevermore. Jesus, our God, oh, nothing, nothing shall be impossible. Your kingdom reigns unstoppable. We'll shout your praise forevermore. Jesus, our God, unstoppable. Nothing shall be impossible. Your kingdom reigns unstoppable. We'll shout your praise forevermore. Jesus, our God, unstoppable.
Your glory. We want to see the impossible done in your name. And we thank you, Jesus, for giving us the authority to speak those things into being. At this time, we will transition into a time of intercession for the nation of Israel. Today, we will be praying for a revelation of Jesus Christ. Please come into agreement with me as I pray through each topic. And then exercise your authority in Christ by lifting up intercession with your own voice. Lord, we thank you that you see broken and contrite hearts, and you do not deny or ignore them. You are the holy and highly exalted one, but you have brought yourself to the lowest of places to meet us, to save the very ones who deny you. Jesus, reveal yourself to Israel, that she may know that it is you who brings comfort. It is you who have dwelled with her from the beginning and continue to dwell with her forever. Make Israel aware of your presence, Lord Jesus, and revive the spirits of those crying out to you as they humble themselves before you in repentance, God. Comfort them with revelation of your Son, Jesus. We prophesy an opening of spiritual eyes to see you and a softness of heart to receive the comfort that you bring. Revelation of you is the greatest comfort to a contrite heart. Let's pray. was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the chastisement that brought us peace, and with his wounds we are healed. God, your faithfulness means you cannot ever break a promise. The love that you spoke over Israel as your firstborn son is still strong. As your people cultivate a genuine trust in you, God, would you reveal the true Messiah, Jesus, to them as proof of your great love, as a revelation of a promise that you've already fulfilled. You, Jesus, were already pierced for their transgressions to bring them healing and salvation. And make this an anchor of hope for them so that they can trust you for even greater things to come. You have not failed them, Lord, and you never will. You are granting them greater knowledge of you. Would you release a right understanding of where they stand now in the context of history and of prophecies yet to be fulfilled? We declare deeper levels of trust than ever before through knowledge of you, Jesus. May Israel boldly claim your promises and know that you have not withheld anything from her. Let's pray.
trust in your promises. We trust in your word that Jesus Christ is Lord over Israel. Oh, we trust in your promises. We trust in your word that Jesus Christ is Lord over Israel.
Promises are everlasting.
Oh, we trust in your promises. Oh, we trust in your word that Jesus Christ is Lord over Israel. And we prophesy. Oh, we trust in your promises. Oh, we trust in your word that Jesus Christ is Lord over Israel, over Israel. We trust in your promises. We trust in your word.
Your word still stands true,
Jesus
God.
Jesus Christ is Lord over Israel. Oh, we trust in your promises. We trust in your word that Jesus Christ is Lord over Israel. Oh, we trust in your promises. We trust in your word that Jesus Christ is Lord over Israel, over Israel. Oh, we trust in your promises. We trust in your word that Jesus Christ is Lord over Israel, over Israel. We trust in your promises. We trust in your word that Jesus Christ is Lord over Israel, over Israel.
Restore to me the joy of salvation and uphold me with a willing spirit. Lord Jesus, you are the Savior. You are the manifestation of salvation for Israel. Pour out upon Israel a true joy by revelation of salvation that has come through Jesus Christ. We declare that Israel's joy will no longer be one that is only from a hope of something to come, but rather a realization of what has already been done. Uphold them and preserve this joy with a willing spirit, a spirit of freedom that conquers any spirit of bondage or hopelessness. This joy will be an unconditional one, one that is solely based on the goodness of Jesus Christ. And no condemnation, no shame, no weight of sin can steal this joy of freedom in Christ. Lord, we fight on behalf of Israel for this joy to come alive with praise and for gratitude to make way for supple hearts. Let's pray. fathers saw in the days of old, would you do it again, Lord? All the stories told, all the miracles, would you do it again? God, you are the God of miracles. You are the God who forms the world, split the seas, turned rivers to blood, brought water from the rock, resurrected the dead, and caused victory in battle through the sound of praise. Show Israel today that what their forefathers saw can be done today in the name of Jesus. Lord, would you move in Israel through your miracles, signs, and wonders to reveal Jesus to them, and teach them to ride on the testimonies of their forefathers. And we prophesy faith and hunger rising up in your people, Israel. Make them both receivers and vessels of your supernatural works. Reveal the power in the name of Jesus Christ. And we speak greater faith and strength for those who already believe. And for those who do not, we speak salvation accompanying your signs and miracles. Thank you, Lord, that you move and you speak powerfully today, and that you desire to encounter your people in supernatural ways. Let's pray. Thank you for your everlasting covenant and love for Israel. Thank you for the love of Jesus that transcends all else. We release over Israel comfort, promise, joy, and miracles in your name. And we trust that you are moved by our prayers to bless Israel with the revelation that you long to release, the revelation of their brother and savior and king, Jesus Christ. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
your revival, Holy Spirit fire, burning ever brighter in our souls. Kings and kingdoms falling, hear your people calling, King of kings, we need a miracle. So we need your revival, Holy Spirit fire, burning ever brighter in our souls. Kings and kingdoms falling, hear your people calling, King of kings, we need a miracle. Oh, we need your revival, Holy Spirit fire, burning ever brighter in our souls. Kings and kingdoms falling, hear your people calling, kings and kingdoms need a miracle. We need your revival, Holy Spirit fire, burning ever brighter in our souls. Kings and kingdoms falling, hear your people calling, King of kings, we need a miracle. Oh, the King, and the King is among us, and His glory surrounds us. Victorious, and revival is rising in His day. And the King is among us, and His glory surrounds us, and His fire is falling as we sing. And the Savior is for us, His love is victorious. Revival is rising in His day. So we need your revival, Holy Spirit fire, burning ever brighter in our souls. Kings and kingdoms falling, hear your people calling, King of kings, we need a miracle. Oh, we need your revival, Holy Spirit
fire, burning ever brighter in our souls.
Kings and kingdoms falling, hear your people calling, King of kings, we need a miracle. And the King is among us, His glory surrounds us, and His fire is falling as we sing. The Savior is for us, His love is victorious, and revival is rising in His name. Oh, the King, and the King is among us, and His glory surrounds us, and His fire is falling as we sing. Savior is for us, and His love is victorious. Revival is rising in His day. So we need your revival, Holy Spirit fire, burning ever brighter in our souls. Kings and kingdoms falling, hear your people calling, King of kings, we need. hearts, Father. We declare that your love is steadfast over Israel. And God, we just call upon you, Lord, the voice of the Lord, the voice that thunders, the voice that breaks the cedars of Lebanon, the voice that breaks but also gives life. God, we call upon that voice to speak forth signs and wonders, to command the revelation of Jesus Christ over your people in Israel. God, we declare that you are moving today, that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And God, we pray for revelation of Jesus Christ as the Messiah over your people in Israel. God, we seal all the prayers that were lifted today. We breathe forth your life, remembering and trusting in your promises and in your faithfulness. God, we seal all that you have done in the mighty name of Jesus. And it's in your name we pray, and all of God's people say, amen. Thank you, everyone, for coming out this morning. We're going to invite you again to come out next week to our K1 Prayer Tabernacle. Hope you're blessed. You have an awesome week. Have a good day.